Hello there. My name is Calvin Louis. I'm a product manager on the Microsoft Entra ID Authentication Experiences team.
And I'm Mayur Santani, product manager on the Microsoft Authenticator app.
Today, we'll talk about passkeys for work and how they can help your organization usher in a phishing-resistant future. As we shared in the 2023 Microsoft Digital Defense Report, attempted password attacks increased more than tenfold in 2023 to over 30 billion per month. Enabling multi-factor authentication still remains the best way to protect your organization. However, we're quickly finding out that MFA by itself is not fully sufficient in today's evolving threat landscape. By the end of June 2023, we observed approximately 6,000 MFA fatigue attacks per day, highlighting the importance of moving towards phishing-resistant MFA to protect against sophisticated remote threat actors. So, how do we protect against these attacks while making sign-ins even easier? Passkeys. For those who are unfamiliar, passkey is the industry-aligned term for W3C WebAuthn credentials, which can be stored in FIDO2 security keys, as well as user devices such as phones, tablets, or PCs. Passkeys leverage standards-based private public key cryptography to authenticate users. To sign in, you simply unlock the passkey using your face, fingerprint, or device PIN. No password needed. Through the possession of the device, which homes the private key, plus the unlock gesture with something you are or something you know, passkey authentication is multi-factor. Finally, passkeys are also built to be phishing-resistant, preventing malicious actors from tricking your users into compromising their credentials. These properties make passkeys easy to use and secure by design. Passkeys come in two types. They can be bound to the device where they were created, or they can sync across your devices, providing robust built-in recovery mechanisms. Imagine you lose your phone and therefore the passkeys on it. With sync passkeys, you don't have to worry about being locked out of your account because your passkeys are still present on your other devices and backed up to the cloud. Thus, sync passkeys address some of the toughest usability and recoverability challenges confronting organizations and to help massively reduce the help desk expenses of recovering and reissuing device-bound passkeys. On the other hand, device-bound passkeys are great where industry or governmental regulation or other higher assurance security policies require them. Users can leverage cross-device authentication to sign in using a device-bound passkey from another device. Today, passkeys are device-bound when they are stored in FIDO2 security keys, Windows Hello for Business, and recently in the Microsoft Authenticator app. These options are supported in Microsoft Entra ID today and will be the focus of our discussion in this video. Speaking of which, Mayur, can you tell us a bit more about the investments that Microsoft has made to get us to today?
Of course. Sounds like it's time for a little history lesson. Almost a decade ago, in 2015, Microsoft started its passwordless journey with the introduction of Windows Hello and Windows Hello for Business. In 2019, we followed the API standards developed by the W3C standards body and enabled web authentication or WebAuthn within Windows Hello. For those familiar with it, this effectively made the credentials stored within Windows Hello and Windows Hello for Business passkeys. In 2021, we also released support for FIDO2 security key authentication in Entra ID. And then, a couple years ago, in 2022, in partnership with the FIDO Alliance, Apple, and Google, we announced our support of passkeys and our commitment to continue growing passwordless authentication. So, it's been a while since we've been on this journey of improving a user's security posture while improving their user experience by making WebAuthn credentials available to them. We're now in the phase where our investments in passkeys are going towards making passkeys ubiquitous. Our recent efforts have been focused on bringing passkeys to the Microsoft Authenticator app so our high security enterprise users can enjoy secure, phishing-resistant authentications right from their phone. I'm delighted to announce that Passkeys in the Authenticator app is now generally available for organizations to deploy. We've also been making investments to enhance the user experience users go through when they leverage Windows Hello for Business. In addition to making passkeys more broadly available as a credential, it doesn't help if users can't use it to sign into their applications. A huge part of our efforts have been to make authentications with passkeys possible across different surfaces. You talk Windows, macOS, Android, iOS, applications, browsers. They're all available to use with passkeys, and if not, rest assured we're working on it. Admins can also require users to use passkeys leveraging conditional access policies that our admin expert Calvin will talk about later. Please look at our documentation online to learn more about supported scenarios. Now that we've made device-bound passkeys available across many different platforms and devices, remember how Calvin talked about sync passkeys earlier? That's a big area where our next set of investments is going. Bringing sync passkeys to enterprise users to help with passkey adoption for the masses. Stay tuned for more updates in this space in the months to come. Calvin, how would an organization actually enable themselves to use passkeys?
It's really easy. As an admin, head over to the Microsoft Entra admin portal. In the authentication methods policy, toggle on the passkey authentication method. This is enough to enable any security key for authentication in your organization. If you want to get more granular, you can enforce key restrictions, set specific AGUIDs, and to enable the Microsoft Authenticator, just check the Microsoft Authenticator checkbox, and that's it. Don't forget to hit save. Additionally, we are working on a re-architecture of the passkey policy to allow for up to 10 group-based configurations, or passkey profiles, for even more admin flexibility when deploying multiple passkey solutions. Stay tuned for a future announcement on passkey profiles. Here in the authentication methods policy, we wanted to call your attention to the Enforce Attestation knob. You may notice it is set to yes. When this is the case, Entra ID will require attestation from FIDO2 security keys and Microsoft Authenticator during passkey registration. At a high level, for FIDO2 security keys, we leverage the FIDO metadata service to ensure that the security key is in fact the model that it claims to be. For Microsoft Authenticator, we leverage iOS and Android APIs to ensure that the app is in fact the genuine Authenticator app published by Microsoft. For more details on attestation, please check out our documentation online.
Congratulations! And just like that, you've enabled passkeys in your organization.
Exactly. Now that passkeys are enabled, you may be thinking about how you'll get your users to adopt the new phishing-resistant sign-in method. Here are some recommendations from us. Get users started on a portable phishing-resistant credential for bootstrapping other devices. This can be a passkey in the Microsoft Authenticator or a FIDO2 security key. For the best phishing-resistant authentication experience, we recommend providing users access to same-device authentication wherever they are. Windows Hello for Business and phishing-resistant sign-in methods with macOS platform SSO, which is in preview, are great solutions for achieving this on desktop. While the Microsoft Authenticator app is ideal for mobile devices on iOS and Android. Ensure that your users can use passkeys on their devices. iOS 17 Plus and Android 14 Plus are required to enable Microsoft Authenticator as a third-party passkey provider. For users who can't meet the latest mobile OS requirements, FIDO2 security keys are a great alternative and can be used with all major platforms. Run phased email campaigns to get your users to register for passkeys. We will be releasing email templates that you can use in your own campaigns. Make sure to paste your campaigns to help avoid help desk volume spikes. After running successful email campaigns, you may find your organization to be ready to go fully phishing resistant. To get started, you can enforce a conditional access authentication strengths policy to require the usage of phishing resistant authentication methods. You may want to start with safe enforcement only on users who have access to a phishing-resistant auth method on the platform where enforcement is taking place. Over time, you can scale out the enforcement. If an enforced user doesn't already have a passkey registered, we now have added support for inline registration to help them quickly go through registration and then move on with whatever they need to do.
It was not long ago when a world where most users are using phishing-resistant authentication was just a dream. During the public preview of passkeys and Authenticator, we learned a lot and have enhanced our user experiences to make passkeys a great authentication method to achieve that dream. With the GA of passkeys in the Authenticator app, the work has been done to make passkeys usable across most platforms and applications. If you haven't already been looking at deploying passkeys, we highly recommend you get started with it. Thanks for watching.